We weren't even allowed, go see our relatives.
As a child, Hillary Johnson was taken from his family and abused in ways he tries not to think about.
I'm a little kid, and I said, who am I supposed to go tell?
Johnson attended the residential school in Williams Lake, B.C. What's heartbreaking is how typical his story is. For more than 100 years, thousands of children were torn away from their families and communities. Johnson's most vivid recollection, another boy standing on a hillside day after day.
Try to find a way home. And there was no way home. It just stood there.
The original sin, as it were, was Europeans moving in and imposing their will on the people who were here first. What to do with people so different? They put them in residential schools.
The high-minded view of the day was not to wipe out the Indians, but to convert them and to assimilate them, to take young Thomas Moore from his people and make him fit in to the new society. What was wiped out was an ordinary childhood, his language, his culture.
Canadians have long since recognized the historic mistreatment of Aboriginal people, but have largely sidestepped addressing it head-on. The harm to residential school kids, and the harm that cascaded down generations of Aboriginal people. The truth is one turning point. Reconciliation is the next.
There has to be healing and restitution to Indigenous peoples and communities in terms of that historical trauma that has been endured for centuries.
The importance of preserving one's culture is understood best by those who had it taken away. Hillary Johnson came to Ottawa for those who could not.
A lot of people at home that went through this, and there's so many, I can't even count it.
One he'll remember is the boy standing on a hillside.
After all these years, even when the place was shut down, that little boy is still there.
Eric Sorenson, Global News, Toronto.